Tell me about this exciting new series called Wedlocked.
Well, Wedlocked, the idea came from my mother. She said, my mother has a million ideas, and she said, you and Lauren should do a spinoff. You guys need to keep working together. And I said to Lawrence, oh yeah, my mom was saying we should do something together. And he's like,
ding, ding,
that's
ding.
A great idea. Hello. Why didn't you tell me this 5 months sooner? And so we started kind of brainstorming about what stories we'd like to tell and what's missing, we think, in television today, and what our strengths are, and we came up with Wedlocked.
Yeah.
What is missing in television today?
I feel like television today, everything's about, this is probably going to sound dramatic, but almost the deconstruction of the marriage and family. Everything's about, these teens getting in trouble and divorce and people who are single that can't find love. And I'm like, where is that place where you see two married people trying to work it out? Where is that place where a family is going to stay grounded and rooted no matter what? Where are our Cosby shows today? And we thought in playing Remy and Christina, because through all their complications, they stuck together. Even when they didn't want to, they stayed together. So we thought, she's recently married and I've been married for 2 years, so we have a lot of stories just about men and women and miscommunications, but when you're married, it's like, we gotta figure this out.
But that's the ultimate goal, is they're a team, they're working together. Robbie and Denise are the two main characters in Wedlocked, and that ultimately they love each other. And that's what our director really has been working on a lot. It's just, okay, so they're going through these things, but we never want to feel like they're really in trouble. We always want to be rooting for these people and feeling like ultimately they love each other, they're having fun.
Like that. Mm-hmm. Now, you mentioned you have a director. You're both producers of this show.
Yes.
Right? Okay, and this came about once Guiding Light had been canceled. You two started brainstorming. Kind of out of the ashes.
We found out about the cancellation April 1st, and I guess he told me your mom said this like around June,
July.
But her mom really told her this like
in April.
So I was like, why didn't you tell me this? But yeah, and even with Crystal's show and our show, we just like working with each other. Most importantly, like the Guiding Light cast is really a tight cast, and the idea of never working with each other again, or the idea of having to wait and hopefully fate will put us in the same. We're like, no, let's work on something, let's work together. And then we got the content. Mm-hmm. Your mom gave us the content. Mm-hmm. So smooth from there.
And it's been exciting to bring other people in, because everyone's been really excited about the project and wanting to work. And it's been so easy. It's been a lot of hard work, to have a promo together and kind of five little webisodes shot after finding out in July that we were going to put this project together is pretty incredible. But it's because everyone is so excited about it and wanting it to be successful, including the fans.
Definitely.
Yeah.
What do you see as the advantages to doing a web series versus trying to go directly to television with this?
I think a web series lets it be interactive. We were setting up many things where characters will tweet, and Robert and Denise will tweet about what happened in an episode, or we can create a video vlog of them talking, or just having the characters interact with the fans in a way that they just can't do on television. Our vision is to have these characters be part of your family. So where soaps make it so they're with you, doing a web series is like they're more than in your living room. They're sitting right next to you.
And also, I think it's for the artist, it's a certain amount of control, that we don't have to wait on a network. We don't have to listen to executives telling us, we will pick up your show if you cut that character and, wear a string bikini and, whatever it is, that we can really do the episodes that we want to do and play the way that we want to play. And also, as far as the interactive aspect of it, we can listen to feedback from the fans and then include that in our episodes and shows, which is really lovely as well.
Mm-hmm. That's great. You mentioned control. Mm-hmm. And I imagine having been actors on a daytime soap opera versus being producers on a web series must be a very different experience in terms of having input and creative control.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You don't have the networks and the producers and the sponsors to answer to. You get to tell the story as you want to.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's that like?
I love it.
Yeah. I imagine.
I love it. But that's nothing against, you know, our experience as just actors, because on Guiding Light is where I really studied the producers, especially in the new model, the new format, on how they shot and how they got everybody together and the decisions they made. And I would often, you know, talk to them about it and talk to directors and just get their different feels. So I learned so much there. But, hello. But having control, and it's not so much having control, because it is a team. It's me, Carl, we have two other producers on this. So we're getting to sit down and bounce it around without a network saying, we need this by this time, mm-hmm. or it has to be done. Like, we just say, you know what? Let's figure out the story first. Mm-hmm. Let's get the story. Let's take whatever time we need for the story. And I feel like that freedom is what you may not have mm-hmm. when you have just other corporations looking. All of a sudden you have the timeline of what you got to do, but
yeah.
It's that time.
And it goes both ways, you know. It's like we have the artistic freedom, but we also are the people who have to get it done at the end of the day, you know. So there's something really wonderful about just going and doing your job and going home, but it's another thing when you go in, you do your job, and then you have yep. to make sure the promo gets out and make
yeah.
sure, you know, because if that doesn't get done, no one else is going to do it for us.
Right. Mm-hmm. And speaking of timelines, I'm amazed and impressed with how fast this is happening. This idea came up in July. You started talking about this idea in July, and here we are. It's going to debut on
November 1st.
That's, I think, a much shorter timeline than you would have had with television, and one of, again, the many advantages to taking your creativity to the web.
Yeah.
What did you learn from the Guiding Light production model that's assisting you now in doing this show?
Wow, well, when we first started the new format, everybody was kind of learning as we went. Producers, directors.
The new Guiding Light format.
The new Guiding Light yeah. format. Everyone's learning as they're going. So I got to see producers troubleshoot and figure out what works. So if you watch the show in its first couple months and in its last couple months, drastically different mm-hmm. the way it's shot. And I got to be a fly on the wall watching them figure it out, how to get to this point and how maybe we don't need to do close-ups all the time, so let's pull back, or we can't shoot in here. But then one director is like, no, I can make it work in here. And then just really seeing how each and every one of them troubleshoots through this, you know, it was tough at first figuring out how to do it, but watching them figure it out, I was just like writing notes mm-hmm. like, that's interesting.
That is really interesting for us to know that some of your success with Weblogs is coming out of some of the challenges from the Guiding Light.
Absolutely.
Was there any talk at any point of having Remy and Christina continue in a web series, or was that never part of the dialogue in doing this?
Well. I don't think, I mean, I think on one hand it's just, I don't think it's contractually possible because they kind of belong to CBS and Guiding Light. But also, you know, Remy and Christina had a very specific story
yeah.
and we loved many things about their story, but then there were things that we were ready to leave behind, and it's great to start fresh with a new couple that is just experiencing life and mm-hmm. in a different way. And there are some similarities there, that playfulness that Remy and Christina had, and the, you know, just that dynamic of staying together and wanting to build a family, and just the trials and errors and the crazy mishaps that they, you know, but Robbie and Dini's have their own flavor, and we're really having a good time exploring that and finding that.